Today, I'm going to demonstrate how to use focus stacking in Affinity Photo. I'm using this to merge three images into one, which will have a greater depth of field. I shot the three images that I'm merging using different focus points. In one image, I placed the point of focus on the foreground. In another, it was in the middle of the frame, and in the other, it was on the bridge in the distance. If we zoom into the first image, you can see that the foreground is sharp, but the bridge and tree branches are blurred. Now if we look at the image where I focused on the bridge, we can see that's sharp, but the foreground isn't. A good tip if you're focus stacking images like this is to name the images using a number to indicate their sequence. This will make fixing problems later much easier, as you'll see. I've also added the word foreground, mid, and distance to the name to make it more obvious where I focused. The other thing that I've done is process the raw files into TIFF images. When you come to do a focus stack or focus merge in Affinity Photo, it's possible to use raw files. The only problem is that the software seems to process the individual raw files before merging them. You then don't have access to apply any capture sharpening or lens correction to the individual images. To produce my starting TIFF images, I've already applied capture sharpening and a lens correction. To merge these images, I'll select File and then New Focus Merge from the menu. This displays the Focus Merge dialog, which is empty. I now need to add my processed TIFF images for merging. When I click the Add button, it opens a dialog where I can navigate to the folder holding my files. If you want to use original raw files for creating the focus stack, you can also open them using this dialog. To add the files, you can select them one at a time, but it's much easier if you select them all. To do this, hold down your Command key if you're using a Mac, or Control key on a Windows PC. Then, whilst holding it down, click the files that you want to select. When I've selected all three of my TIFF images, I can click Open to add them to the Focus Merge dialog. At this point, I could add more images if I needed to, or remove any images that I've added in error. But as I'm happy with the images I've selected, I'll click the OK button to start the merge process. We now see Affinity Photo go through the process of automatically aligning the images. This ensures the main features and objects in the scene line up. After that, it selects the main areas of focus from each of the three images to merge them into a single image. When it's done, we see the merged image along with the Sources Studio panel. If we look at the Sources panel, we also see the three TIFF images displayed as thumbnails. Overall, Affinity Photo has made a good job of merging the three images, but there are a couple of problem areas that we need to fix. If I magnify the image to 200% and then position the navigator on the bridge, you can see the tree branches have moved. This has created a ghosting effect because the software detected areas that were in focus in two of the images. It's therefore used the branches and leaves from both sets of images in the focus merged image. This also highlights the need to use a tripod when shooting the images for the focus stack, because any movement between the images could show up as ghosting. Also, if you're shooting a nature scene like this, there's likely to be something in the frame that moves. This means that you need to inspect the merged image closely to find these areas and repair them. Now to the feature that's going to help us make this repair, which is in the Sources panel. This allows us to compare the individual images with the merged image. You can see how this works with an example if I select the foreground image. This is the one where the foreground is in focus, but not the background. After selecting the image, I can click the eye icon to the bottom of the Sources panel. We then see the source image rather than the merged image, which allows us to compare the two. As you can see, the source image is out of focus in this area and hasn't been used in the focus stacked image. Our problem with the ghosting must therefore be caused by the other two images. If I click those with the Sources preview option turned on, you can see how the branches have moved between the two frames. Let's say that we decide to use the area from the third image, which has the focus point in the distance. To do this, turn off the Sources preview option by clicking the eye icon again so that we see the merged image. Then with the image I want to use selected in the Sources panel, I can paint over the problem area. As I move my mouse pointer over the area, you can see a preview of how the result will look if I apply a brush stroke. To apply the change, click and paint over the area using your mouse. This tells Affinity Photo to use that area of the source image with the focus merged image, which is then updated. I can then use the Navigator panel to move around that area of the image, finding problems and fixing them. The tool we're using to do this, by the way, is the clone brush, and it was automatically selected after the focus merge. Watch what happens to the sources panel if I select a different tool. The thumbnails in the sources panel now vanish. It's only when I have the clone brush selected that we see the images. The only difference when we're using the clone brush to fix the focus merged image is that you don't need to bother setting a sample point. The software does that automatically, making it simple to fix problem areas. Now let's look at another problem area, which is the water in the foreground. For this, I'll reduce the zoom to 100% in the Navigator panel. If you look at the surface of the water and the light, you can see it looks a bit odd. This is also being caused by ghosting because we have the detail from two images being combined in this area. As before, let's turn on our sources preview and use it to check the source images. If I select the foreground image, you can see that it's soft in this area. But if I select the mid-focused image, it's sharp, as is the distance-focused image. The mistake I made when shooting the three images is that I used too small an aperture. This captured too much depth of field in each image, meaning two of them are in focus in the same areas. For this focus merge, I could probably have used only images 1 and 2, but I wanted to make this point and show you how the software works. Let's now fix the problem by using only the area from image 2 in the focus stack. As before, I'll turn off the source preview option. Then with image 2 selected in the sources panel, I can click and paint over the area. As I'm painting, you can see the surface of the water change to remove the unwanted detail. When I get to the rocks in the foreground, I just need to be careful not to paint over them. If you do make a mistake, use the undo command in the menu or press Command and Z on your keyboard. If you're using a Windows PC, that's Control and Z. Let's zoom out now to see the full image. An easy way to do this, by the way, is double-clicking the merged pixel layer in the Layer Studio panel. Now another technique that involves merging multiple images is to produce a panorama. To see how that's done in Affinity Photo, watch this video next. Thanks for watching today, and I hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and please share this with other Affinity users. I'll see you soon for another video.